Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. The big idea today is that different types of matter allow heat energy to move through them at different speeds. Take a look at this pot. What's the purpose of the pot? It heats things up. Heat energy travels through it. I said different types of matter allows heat energy to move through them at different speeds. Well, this pot has two different types of matter. The top part's steel, and the bottom part's copper. Why is the copper on the bottom? Why not reverse it? Sounds like I need science to answer that question. Now, I can't see heat energy moving through matter. I can't see the heat energy moving through this pan. But using science, we can show you how quickly that heat energy moves using this demonstration. I have two candles that are going to provide our heat energy, and we have our two different types of matter. We have a copper rod and a steel rod. Clothespins are our little stand. We have our timer. But what are these pink dots? Well, we needed something to show you the heat energy moving down the rods, so we took wax from a birthday candle and put little drips along our rod. As the heat energy moves down the rods, it melts the wax, and we should be able to see the heat energy moving down the rod and how quickly that heat energy is moving down each rod. Is it moving more quickly down this rod, or is it moving more quickly down this rod? Let's take a look. Our candles are lit and we're ready for our race to begin. I'm going to slide these candles under our rods, providing the heat energy, and I want you to watch carefully to see how quickly that heat energy is moving down the rods. Once I slide the candles under, we'll start the clock and the race begins. Here we go. So the flames are starting to provide heat energy, and that heat energy wants to move. It wants to move down our rods. And it doesn't look like anything's happening. It doesn't look too exciting at all because you can't see it. But once that heat energy gets to these first two drops, they're going to start to melt. If you look very carefully at each of these dots, you'll see the bottom starting to melt on each one. It looks like the copper is melting a little bit more than the steel. If I look carefully at the copper, I can almost see the second dot of wax starting to melt a little bit. Nothing's happening on my steel dot. Both dots are starting to melt. That means the heat energy's the copper went down first. Wait a second, it must mean the heat energy is moving a little more quickly through the copper. This is starting to melt. Now the race is heating up. The second dot on the copper is starting to melt. It's almost ready to go. I have the first dot on my steel. That's melted, but the second dot's not melting at all. I can really see this dot starting to melt. Wait, my third dot's starting to melt on my copper. That heat energy is moving more quickly down this copper. I can see it with my eyes. Take a look at our second dot on the steel. No melting. It's moving more slowly. The second dot on the copper is ready to go. Oh, wow, take a look. I move over, the fourth dot on the copper is actually starting to melt now. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 dots on the copper starting to melt. Only one dot on the steel. The second dot has not even started to melt. The second dot, look at the dot on the copper, it's down. My third dot on the copper is ready to melt. Fourth dots. My fifth dot is starting to melt on the copper. We can see the heat energy moving down the copper. It's not even moving down the steel. Well, it is, but it's moving slowly. We're at 3 minutes, and I'm almost melting my third dot. My second dot hasn't even started to melt on my steel. The third dot's getting ready to go. Oh, it goes down. Let's hit the stop. Let's hit the stop. Let's blow out the candles and let's take a look at what happened. You can see 1, 2, 3 wax dots melted on the copper, but only one melted on the steel. Why? That heat energy was moving much more quickly down the copper. The heat energy was moving much more slowly down the steel. So why is the copper on the bottom part of the pot? Through science, we've discovered that different types of matter allow heat energy to move through them at different speeds. Scientists call that conduction. And our demonstration shows us that the copper allows the heat energy to move through it more quickly. Science is so cool. So it makes sense that copper goes on the bottom and the steel's up at the top. But what about the handle? Well, some matter conducts heat energy really well. Some matter doesn't. This handle doesn't really conduct heat energy all that well. Don't forget to check out our links in our video description. Thanks for watching.